No one's playing fucking chess this time. Your fanfiction is in the library.
What about this messed up erotica?
Yeah, it's unfortunately.
Even that fanfiction that I wrote when I was 15?
Especially that one. We have a specific section just for that one.
Damn.
Do not touch haunted, it says.
Good thing I've never written anything in my life.
Hey, noodles are ready. Everyone knows you make noodles by putting an egg in the microwave.
For sure.
And make a mess. I am a mess. A hot mess, hopefully, but a mess regardless. Hello, everyone. I'm the noodle doodler. Hey, how you doing?
I thought you were an egg.
I feel like we never get enough time to talk. How have you been?
I'm good, buddy. I missed you.
The week is too long.
It's been an entire week.
It's been a week. Anyway, what a week it's been.
Hell yeah. Stuff happened in an order that had great effects on the world. Anyway, I'm Kelvin, a.k.a. the Noodle Doodler, a.k.a. Noodle Goon, a.k.a. your Gonk Master for this evening. I gotta find a fifth title so I can start beating out Daenerys Targaryen. But for now, I have yet to, and we are playing Cyberpunk Red, a delightful systems place setting place in the 2040s, in which our group is going on to heist the currently small company of Cyber Matrix. They become a lot bigger in the future, but they're hanging on right now. I'm saying that you're not going to take out Cyber Matrix with this. You're just going to... You're the reason they don't become popular until the 70s. So last we left off, we were doing a heist movie third wipe at a time, showing each of you. And it looks like last we left was Ares. But if there's an order you guys want to do events in, I'm welcome to any order. You know, if I was smart, I would have made a street at some point between this week and last week. But I didn't do that. So why don't we start with someone, anyone but Video James. No offense, Rux.
Anyone but Video James. Damn, yeah, I was thinking he should go, but okay.
Full offense taken.
No, we should start with Chrome, because he has the most potential to fuck this up.
He really does.
If you go first, we can bail you out.
It's kind of bad how much he's got. You know, he's got to worry.
Please step into the storage closet with me.
The stairwell... there is a stairwell. Let me look at a different area to see where exactly it is. So the stairwell is located in the back here. That's kind of what this ladder represents. So I guess it's more of a ladder than a stairwell, but, you know, what could go wrong? Okay.
And then you need to get the gang Jazzler.
Yeah, your job is to get the gang Jazzler, which is in this room. Unless your plan is completely unrelated and someone else is going to have to come up here later and get the gang Jazzler. I cut out some of the planning time last week with an implied 2 weeks of prep. So I will let anyone flash. What did you do for Holiday Heist? Was it 2 flashbacks each? I'm going to give you guys each 2 flashbacks to flashback to of things you did in the last 2 weeks that you can call upon in your time of need.
Okay.
It can't be like something you couldn't see coming. You couldn't be like, on the off chance that they summon Atom Smasher, I bring my specifically designed Atom Smashing robot. On the off chance that Atom Smasher, who is, I don't believe, currently considered alive.
At the moment, no. No, he's in Japan, I think, currently. A construct at the moment.
Yeah. Mostly goo. Anyway. Blaze and I are always in a competition to see who remembers the most cyberpunk lore. Which is a problem, because I'm the DM.
I will win this.
Okay. You're running. We're gonna leave you where I left you last time, and we're gonna go ahead and roll a little initiative here. A miniature initiative.
A miniitiative?
Yeah, you got it.
It's my favorite vacation spot, Portmanteau.
Hey, boo. Get the fuck off the stage, young man.
It does sound like a place in Newfoundland, though.
Mm-hmm.
See, he got me there. All
right.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, buddy.
An 8 plus 7. That's going to be 15. Write it on your thing. Okay. What is a reflex for a bodyguard? It is 6. Which means that the bodyguard's got a 7.
You click on your person and type it in, click enter.
Dr. Christopher Amon gets a plus 8. Which means he actually also got a 15.
And he can also dodge bullets.
He can also dodge bullets. That's a fun fact of the day. We all gotta remember that from time to time, that Super Christopher Armwell can dodge bullets.
Oh no, it's an 8.
Okay, descending. I'll put you before him. Alright, it's your turn, Maestro. That means you can move 6 spaces. You can, if you don't want to spend your action, you can spend your next action to also move, like your action to also move. Into the hold on, I'm doing something else while I listen, so I gotta. Okay, so Ryder, you now know that you got to meet him in the elevator because he planned to fuck up. You can input on this flashback if you want, because planning for failure is insane. When I immediately fuck up.
Boom. If you decide to drag me in to a firefight in an elevator, I'm not coming.
You immediately, as you hear on the other side, he's in the elevator, get your guns out. He cornered himself. Everyone, get your guns out. As you just regret. Yet.
Yet.
I'm just being an asshole. They don't actually say that. I'm just being an asshole.
They're doing a lot of heavy lifting.
Yet. Yeah, this ain't very intense yet. Rest assured, crimes will come.
He's suspicious of the word in the elevator. Get your gun out.
He sprinted to the elevator. Shoot on sight.
Go running in the building!
Little gay little jaunt.
Called a gay little jaunt.
Yeah, like gay speed walking.
So long.
It's so descriptive. I love it.
Ooh, okay. Just a gay little. Whilst, yeah. Doing drugs, I am going to say, is an action. I'll do drugs later, fine. Dad. okay. Well, with that, I think, I will finish out this round of initiative, and then we will cut to somewhere that isn't here. As we play around in the space. Back to Christopher Armwell. In case you were wondering, his move is 6. He's just, he's running, but I would like to say he's more just walking with like a coffee mug in his hand. And it is just, are you fucking kidding me? She is going to... She's going to walk into this room, and who knows what she's doing in there. Okay. And then... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Yeah, but yeah. It's the corporate office. Let's see here. That's gonna be a brawl check, my man. You can go ahead and do it. They got an 11 on their brawl check. I think you do evasion, but...
Yeah, it's brawl v evasion. Yeah. Oh, fuck yeah.
Oh, my. Well, He goes to grab you. You just slip out of the way, but you're now in the elevator with two guys. Which floor did you input? Oh, do you want me to remind you all the floors? Mm-hmm.
But he's on three. Ryder's on three.
Yeah. Okay. There's two of them, and you just sprinted away, so they think you've stolen something or some shit.
He's got the gang Jazzler! Get him!
He's got the thing. Go after him.
He's stolen the MacGuffin!
Okay. So... the age-old problem, a line of ducks. Now we can cut over. So we find ourselves pulling in near the clinic. I'll say for now you're here and Jason's here. Feel free to put yourself on the map. Did I move you all? Did I do it right? Yeah, you should all be seeing the new map.
Yep.
Yes.
So Jason is waiting. The clinic is here. Jason is here. You guys do have an earpiece to each other to communicate. Rooks.
All right. So I'm on the delivery route. Where did you say Jason was? I'm sorry, I missed the...
Jason is currently on the screen.
Okay.
He was also, he was like...
I refreshed it. He was not on my screen. So.
He's sitting on the side of this planter, smoking a cigarette and twirling a gun. And it's like a pistol. All
right, so I make the world's slowest drive-by and just kind of slowly pass him.
So as you get about here... He gets in the way and holds out a gun.
I do the. Okay, I'm sorry. What can I do for you, sir?
Yeah, I'm gonna need you to pull over now.
Sure. I'll pull on over for you. One moment.
Where do you want to park in this area?
I guess I'll park going back, like, where that U-turn is, where it's, okay. Like, in that shady area.
You, like, here?
Like, can I ping with this thing? Like, this area?
Oh, yeah, gotcha.
Yeah, so, like, pull on that way, and, that way it's, like, a little bit in the shade and of the building, and a little bit less in vision of surrounding eyes.
Yeah.
I'll have him, toss me out of the truck.
Mm-hmm. You can drag your character onto the screen.
Yeah, I gotta remember how to do that. There we go. I'm not nervous, Steve. There we go. God, I wish I was.
I wish I was nervous, Steve.
Right. I have him kind of like push me out of the truck. And
get on the fucking ground. Yeah!
Have him rough me up a little bit.
Do a performance check.
It's not even a performance. Have him punch me. I'm bleeding. I'll take the damage. I don't care.
Yeah, he's a Taekwondo. So he can take you across the face. Let me roll. I guess he wouldn't even need to roll to hit because you're letting him do it.
Yeah. I gotta sell the gig here. Be like, I got punched in the face. Like,
You take 7 at half armor, so that would be basically like 3 damage.
3 damage? Okay.
Yeah.
Knocks me down to 42 hit points.
Oh, shit.
That's the lowest I've been the entire time. The first time I've been touched was intentional. All right, so I make sure that he leaves a nice mark, you know, bloody nose, black eye, the works. And while he's, like, roughing me up, I slip him the sheet of paper that has the instructions to unlock the GPS security system stuff.
Yeah, as he leans in, he makes it seem like he's getting the keys from you, which I think he is also doing.
Yep.
And then, yeah. Fucking, if you know what's good for you, you stay there.
I'm sorry. I'm just the driver.
Yeah. You're lucky I don't shoot the messenger.
Blaze is remembering this is not Jason's voice and is very amused by what he's... anyway, he's going to walk up and he unlocks the back. He starts pulling everything out. Let's look at the skills real quick because I do need some check for this. I can't just let this work.
Just let this work. No, it's fine.
Come on. Sometimes things just work. This ain't it.
It could just work. You didn't probably think about it, but it could.
You know what?
Just work.
All right. Here's what we will do. I will have. Let's see. Not all the skills here. It's basically what we're rolling against is no one calling the cops before this finishes.
Okay. Is there, other than using your luck like stuff to do it, is there a luck roll?
No.
Okay.
I'm looking to see, like, if there's anything I could justify to have you be, like, have that be what you do. Yeah, I guess gamble.
I guess we're gambling on the time it takes them to do this, right?
Yeah, I will have you both roll.
Okay.
But I will have your roll matter more than his, because I don't want it to mess up, because I rolled badly. And it's so good I said that, because he rolled a 1. Plus some more, but we'll see what his stats are.
I rolled an 8, and I have an 8 in gamble, so that's a 16.
Okay, so I will tell you what. The collective number I had in my head, you are just shy of. So I will say that I need a random NPC real quick. I will say that about a third of the way through getting everything done, you do see someone. Johnny Two Knives.
That's Johnny Two Knives again?
Oh, shit, where is he?
No, shit.
What the heck was he in? Was he in a dark modern world? I think he was. Let's see, God, where'd he go? There he is. Johnny Two Knives is calling the cops. Johnny Two Knives don't like seeing justice around here. That's why I have both these knives to protect everyone. And he said, "I like to whittle." That's Johnny Two Knives.
I like to whittle a little.
I've never caused a drop of bloodshed because that's not Johnny Two Knives' way.
These two knives are two tools. They're not two weapons. They use them for my art.
I love Johnny Two Knives. Unfortunately, he will be coming back now. Unless someone shoots him right now. Which Johnny gives you. Johnny, you're Johnny. Jason, that's his name. Yeah. Jason gives you the look of like basically he's mouthing like, do I shoot him or do we fucking book it?
Oh, I hang on. Give me a minute to deal. Let me see if I can talk to him. But like, hey, it's all right. Everything's fine.
Everything's insured.
Yeah, it's insured. Everything's cool. I fail getting out of the truck. He's just helping me.
Helping you with what? Because that doesn't make a performance check.
All right.
Make a... What's the fucking check?
Persuasion. acting, maybe?
Acting. Well, let's see. Let me look at it.
It could be persuasion. It could be acting.
It could be streetwise.
It could be streetwise. It could be wardrobe and style. You never know. It is Johnny Two Knives.
I'll let it be. I'll do what I did last time, which I'll have Jason roll a wardrobe and style check, and you roll a streetwise check to see if you can pitch it and if he can look the part.
My streetwise is not very good. I was a farmer.
Okay.
Oh, but I rolled a zero on a d10 is a 10, right?
Yeah, which means you got what I wanted, which is a 20.
All right, cool.
Because he got 10 over Jason.
Radical. Well, technically I got a 16, but...
I was hoping for a collective 20 between
collective
the two.
Collective 20, cool. It's all right, man. I asked him for help.
You know what? Why doesn't Johnny Two Knives help you to make up for hard times?
Hey, extra hands help with the load, right, Jason?
That's all right with me.
Southern accent.
He's really trying to find him. Yeah. He wanted a less intimidating voice than yeah. that's all right with me.
If you want to, I'll slip you 10 eddies.
Hey, I like that part where you said a name that isn't my name. Pleasure to meet you. The name's, Jacob. Jason as a joke. It's a whole thing.
His father's name is Jay.
Yeah, you know how it goes, huh? And then Johnny goes, your voice is starting to match mine. And he goes, what a weird coincidence.
It's just a habit. Weird habit.
I hate what we've done here today.
I honestly think that being acting awkward in a situation with a random NPC is how a heist would go.
Yeah, so you three, you just collectively bring everything to Jason's car.
Thanks, man. I'm gonna pay the dude 15 eddies. Be like, listen, I told you 10, but you were a big help. I'm gonna give you 15, all right?
Hey, yo, Johnny. All right, man. He puts the knife away and he goes, high five.
Yeah, high five. Yeah.
Johnny, two high fives, huh?
Kids still high five, right?
Yeah, I guess so. it's totally retro, you know? That's what Johnny.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I guess that goes off without a hitch. If you guys want to be a getaway vehicle, I will say you can get back to your car or whatever vehicle you brought Rosie on this mission, right?
Rosie's in the basement, so I have to.
I will let you roll a d10, and that will determine how long it's going to take you to get back.
Okay, so upwards of 10 minutes, basically. Boy, these lifesaver mints are delicious. That's a 10. I rolled another 10.
You will be there in 10 minutes.
I will be back. All right, when we're... Well, I'm gonna what do you call it? I have a radio set in Rosie. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna give one of them to Jason so he can, like, be in on the loop now. Mm-hmm. I'm assuming that we would have done this already, but it's just part of the deal. And I'm gonna put a encrypted broadcast... Because I have a scrambler descrambler with the radio communicator, so you guys would be able to descramble my message. But I'm going to put out a beacon saying that 10 minute ETA to back to the building.
All right. We cut over to Ryder. Ryder, where the fuck are you, Ryder? You're on the data floor, aren't you?
I'm on the data floor.
Ryder, in your headset, you hear. You hear, we got a suspicious behavior on a potential suspect heading to the ground floor. Suspicious behavior on a potential suspect heading to the ground floor. You just hear that in your earpiece. You don't, you can not, you know, concern yourself with that if you want. But you are currently, you enter the scan and you hear Natasha over the intercom go, you're not authorized to go. She was vaguely German, I think. Natasha says you are not authorized to go here.
I just need to have a quick conversation with you.
Make a conversation check. Or persuasion, whatever you're better at.
Persuasion, please. That is a 9 for a total of 21.
Well, I'll say with that, she... Natasha is watching you.
Oh, don't get me wrong, I am well aware. I begin to walk this way.
Yeah, she's assumedly watching you.
And I get to, and I knock on the door. Knock, knock, knock.
She slides around, and the door opens.
Wonderful. Hey, so I just needed to discuss something with you regarding the newest installation of the software on Ground Floor 3. And as I begin to walk up to her, I will reach behind and slam her head on the desk.
Okay. We'll call that a brawl check. She's going to make an evasion with, I don't know if disadvantages in the system, but I'm imposing it anyway. Because you caught her flat-footed. I'm implementing an advantage anyway. It's probably called something else.
Could be 15. I could roll luck if I wanted to attempt to go higher.
Okay.
It's pretty middling.
I believe I'm not supposed to tell you whether or not you pass or fail before you choose to do luck. So
yeah, you should not. No, you know what? I won't burn luck because I know I have 2 attacks.
Alright, got her stats pulled up. Sorry, didn't think you were going to fight her.
I'm hoping to knock her out.
Let's see. Her, she got a 17. I can't remember what you said you got.
15.
So you go to slam her head down, she immediately like grabs your wrist, moves around, and slams it against the table. That doesn't do any damage, you just have an attack now.
Yeah, I will go for a headbutt.
Okay, another evasion check. Now she's not rolling with disadvantage.
Yep.
She didn't need it, I guess.
That's a 16.
She got a 12, so you go for the headbutt.
Yep.
Roll some damage.
Okay. I believe it's 2d6 with mm-hmm. my... Or maybe it's 3d6 with my body score.
It's a 3d6 with your body score. We established this last time.
Okay.
The bar fight.
1, 4, 2 for 6 total.
Even for half her armor, that's not going to do any damage. Unfortunately.
Don't melee attacks ignore armor?
No, they half armor.
Oh, okay.
Which is convenient for this. But even with half armor, that is just barely not hurting her.
That is big suck.
All right, well, bud. Let's, I guess, roll the top of floor into initiative.
Yep.
So... Turn for Ryder, a turn for Natasha.
With San Devastan.
Admin.
Oh.
You knew you were about to start a fight, so I will say you got your San Devastan off.
I will burn that. And I will also, I'll put all of my points into precision attack now.
Okay.
Which is just 1 point, but it gives me +1 to attack.
That's still nice.
Yeah. My initiative is plus reflex, so 15, 18.
I'll go ahead and put that in.
Yep.
What was the stat block I used for Nervous Steam?
Bodyguard, I believe.
No, I used a better one for him because of Bit. Because as a bit, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
I would like to flashback if I can.
Flashback.
Earlier this morning, I would have called Steven and said, "Hey, Steven, how you feeling this morning after last night?"
I think that was a week and a half ago, actually. But all right, let's see how that again last night.
I'm pretty sure we did, man. We had a great time.
Oh, he does not remember that, but he goes, "Oh yeah, no, I you're right."
Anyway, Steven, I just wanted to make a quick ask a huge favor.
Mm-hmm.
So on the data floor today, I'm gonna call you in, right? To take my spot, and I just need you to hold that room, and just don't let anybody through if you can, yeah?
Okay, yeah, I'll try. I can't promise anything.
Thank you so much, Steven. I gotta say, man, you're a real one.
Thanks, man.
A right and proper Chumba.
Thanks. I really do try. I am a southern guy. Let's see here. Mooks and grunts. This guy's a bit of a mook and a grunt, if you will. That's plus six to his. Somehow better than most of the people in this. First up is Ryder. You have your actual turn now.
Do I see a data slot right in front of me or anywhere?
This is her main net running setup, so I will say yes.
Is she jacked in?
She's not currently because you were coming in, so she is not.
Ah, shit. Well, that would have been fun. I'll take Dasha's shard out of my pocket and slot it.
It's a good action. You have your movement if you want it.
Nope. No, I'm going to stay right here. Does she have a gun on her?
Mm-hmm.
Then I'll stay close.
She has a big iron on her hip, much like yourself.
Okay. Along with my four other medium-sized irons on my backside, my rifle in my coat, and my body shield on my back.
Big iron on his head.
Big iron on his head.
All right.
The work my belt is doing is unreal.
It's insane, honestly.
Damn, he moves quick. How do you fucking know?
That's his... you don't know what he's doing yet, but that's his dash, so he's not... He's not fully... that's really slow, is like four movement. He just spent his action to dash. Natasha! I think Natasha's gonna kind of go, "Oh! Now I get it." And she's gonna put a gun to your tummy and fire.
Okay.
Yeah, so she like puts her hand on your shoulder, shoves the gun to your stomach, and can she fail this roll? Actually, is she good at shooting? I didn't bother to check. Let's see here. She has a plus 15.
As a netrunner?
Yep.
Oh my lord.
Netrunners are considered lieutenants in the boss hierarchy.
She cannot fail, I believe, at this range. Unless she rolls a one.
Oh, interesting. I actually just looked. The netrunner in the book has only a plus 10, whereas on this website I found that I'm looking at, it says plus 15. So I'm going to go with the book on the plus 10.
Good idea.
Yeah. I just noticed. I just happened to be in the slot where her thing was, but let's see. She needs to get at that. She needs to get a three or higher on the die, and she got a five. So that's going to be very heavy pistol, which is 4d6.
Gonna hurt.
It's gonna hurt. 1, 2, 3, 4. Not a crit. 15 damage. What's your armor at?
11.
So it drops down to 10, and you take 4 damage as she shoots a hole right through your armor. and she goes, Natasha's going to give you one more opportunity to surrender.
I promise, Senorita, you're going to live to regret that.
At least you think I'm going to live. Natasha does not understand. Well, Nervous Steve is going to guard this door and hold his action for anyone to try to go through it. Let's do one more round in here, and then we'll switch to the next place. Go for it.
Okay, first thing I'll do is, I'll ring up Dasha. Can I do that as a free action, or no?
You can.
Okay.
I'll let you, just...
I'll beep, ring up Dasha. I assume she doesn't answer right away, so I'm going to pull, two of my medium pistols out. Dive backwards against this wall and bang bang.
Mm-hmm.
Because they have a rate of fire of 2.
Alright, make them.
This is 2 shooting checks. I have plus 13 to this. I don't think I can fail.
As we established, you could roll a 1. Yes.
True facts, but I do have luck. That is an 8 for the first one, and for the second one, that'll be a 6.
Alright, roll the damage.
Okay, that is 4d6 total.
Mm-hmm.
Uh,
make sure that they're kind of separated so you can keep track if there's a crit.
Right, okay, so first one, second one.
Okay.
First one is a 1 and a 4 for 5, so for the first one I deal 5. For the second shot, 6 and a 2 for 8. So for a total of 13, I believe.
Pink.
All for armor.
Yeah.
Okay.
I will double check, but I don't believe damage is collective for the round against armor. But I will double check. I think each of those does damage individually. Let's see here.
Okay.
Come on. Where is armor? But yeah, so both of those individually are underneath her armor rating.
Okay, and as I create some distance for her, I will push off the wall and come to her left.
Okay.
Precision... Hold on, what does precision attack do again? I'm pretty sure it's just a plus 1.
Yeah.
But you can totally progress on the round if you'd like.
Okay.
Plus 1 to any attacks made, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, and then I guess with my 1 point left over, I will have put another in initiative reaction, or actually threat detection. Just increasing my perception up by 1.
Natasha says, don't say I did not give you opportunity to leave. And she's going to shoot again. She gave you opportunity to leave, my friend.
True facts. We're gonna find out.
We fuck around. What do we do next? We find out.
You will die.
That is an 18 to hit, which will do it.
Mm-hmm.
And that... Oh, just barely not a crit. Just barely you skirted by. That is, however, 19.
19, so I take 9 damage.
Yeah, and your armor's down to 9.
Yeah.
You are impressive. Take multiple shots to kill. This is unusual for Natasha. Natasha is good shot. She seems surprisingly calm right now.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she's just kind of interested to see what you're up to. She saw you slot something in. We're still waiting on him. So that brings us to the top, and we are going to move over to Ares, who we've not visited yet today. Ares, you caused a commotion over here to get the guards out of the way, but Tyland is still over there. What are we doing?
I need to get that gun out of her hand.
I want to immediately
looks like I'm breaking arms.
Flash to a flashback.
Okay.
Of just like group session, I imagine Dasha's there, and I'm just asking, like, hey, what do we know about Tyland? What can I use against him?
Tyland's a bit of a blank slate in a lot of ways. He smokes on his off days and on his on days. He got the job through a little bit of nepotism, but the person who gave him the job is no longer with the company. I don't know why I was putting rasp on my voice, like that's what Dasha sounds like. Other than that, he doesn't... I don't think he cares too much about his job, for what that helps.
Okay. If that you might give me actually be helpful.
I was gonna say, if you give me more of a prompt, I might, but...
I'm just like, what can I distract him with?
A convincing... Smoke break
sounds like yeah. the best.
That could work.
Do you have any, like, good brands that I can maybe, like, prompt him with?
We're back at the group. I think he likes vanilla cigarettes, but no one smokes those, so I don't even know where you'd get them.
I'll find something.
Rux buys him out every time that he goes.
You gotta go to my boy Joey. Come on, I'll show you.
Yeah, mine tastes like agave.
Vanilla is the finest of the flavors.
Agave's just...
You're all crazy, I swear. You see Dasha take a hit from her smoked Gouda cigarette?
Smoked Gouda. Smoked Gouda.
Yeah.
That's actually interesting, though.
Savory...
You have a problem with my savory cigarettes?
I think you like provolone would be also a good one. I don't know.
I tried the Pepper Jacks, but they weren't for me. I like a little bit of a smoother flavor.
The Pepper Jacks just inhaling pepper spray.
Too late, motherfucker! It's canon! And you can't get rid of this book!
Yeah.
All these stories are in the library, motherfucker! Somewhere in the library! It
smells like cheese!
What else? Why wouldn't you want to smell like cheese?
Yeah, you guys look down at the charcuterie board she had made for everyone.
Yeah, these are my salami cigarettes, and these ones are Swiss.
I was about to make
honestly, for me, it's mostly just been about the sweetness of the agave, like.
I'm so glad that we've talked so much about flavored cigarettes. I will be contacting the team that is making all of the expansions for Cyberpunk Red to pitch.
Yeah, Birdie bots every flavor cigs.
I will be contacting Talisorian Games in order to get in the newest supplement. Look it up, it's Talisorian Games.
Woo, okay, so...
Alright, so flashback over. That was all a flashback.
Yes. So I pop over to Tylan's desk, vanilla cigarettes in my hand.
Hey, dude, where'd you find these?
A friend hooked me up.
Lately my boy Joey has been sold out every time. He says some old guy's been coming and buying them all up.
I must have just got lucky.
Oh, fuck. I don't suppose you got one of those for me.
Oh, yeah, no, this is for you. I don't smoke.
Ah, cool. I'm gonna go smoke in one of these meeting rooms, and you're gonna pretend you didn't see me go over there, right?
Yeah, no. Lips are sealed.
Yeah, right. He's gonna go smoke in a meeting room.
Okay, and I immediately slip behind and access his computer.
Yeah, you see he's putting like a wet towel under the like door frame so the smoke doesn't get out.
This guy knows the tricks. This guy grew up with strict parents.
That hit Blaze hard. Blaze immediately knew what
this guy knows.
Smoky
my
out.
My parents don't know I do drugs.
My parents grow weed for a living. Get cooler parents, fuckers.
Mine are both abusive. I hate them both. I call them relatives.
James, how's your family like?
I love my kid. He's the best.
He's great. We love a loving father around here.
Oh, yeah.
Apparently there's two in the whole show, and one of them is my dad.
One of my favorite Minecraft YouTubers just made a family channel, and he was running around in Universal and Disney World Minecraft with his daughters. It was the cutest thing ever.
Anyway. No, cute. We're fucking committing crimes. People are dying on other floors.
I am one of those people.
Ryder has two bullets in his stomach. I assume they didn't pass through the other side, but they might have. I don't know.
I load up Minecraft 1.30 on Tylan's computer as a decoy.
Okay. There are so many people in this office. Yes, that was the part that was weird about this. Anyway,
we're on 1.20 right now, so it's 1.30 then.
It's the future, you see. I'm gonna have you make two checks. One of them is a persuasion to make it look like you know what you're doing, and two is a human perception to see if any of the 40 people in this office notice that you're doing something weird. Okay. I don't know if that's the count, hold on. I'm just gonna save 30 people in this office. Someone can actually count them,
but
I won't.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5,
someone
six,
can count
seven,
them quietly.
Eight, nine.
Okay, so that's
33, actually.
Ah, that was close.
Persuasion?
Yeah, persuasion to blend in. Human perception, okay. See if anyone notices you.
Okay, 13 for persuasion.
Okay.
After burning a luck. Ooh, and 20 for human perception.
You see this guy right here that I'm willing to bet there's a chance Blaze did not count. He is going to immediately turn to walk into the shaft where the security guards are.
Okay.
So, he's presumably going to go tattle on you. Make a security check. Yeah. Make a security check. See if you could do it fast enough to not get caught.
I'm gonna burn another luck gun. Can I use luck twice on the same roll?
No.
Fucking damn it, and that was security. I think I get a plus 14 for that.
I think I'm finding the best at that. I don't remember.
Damn it, every time I close the thing, I need, like, all my stats on a separate thing.
By the way, if Ryder dies, I want you all to know that I have 3 backups planned.
He has told me all 3 of them.
Yeah, security tech check is 14, so that's a 16.
It's not enough. You're installing some very complex software. All right, we're gonna give. We're not gonna roll an initiative.
Can Gadget have a move?
Is Gadget here? Because I believe you were specifically told don't bring your cat to the office by Tyler.
I snuck her in so
she's in the closet. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah,
drag her over here to start.
Okay.
Does whatever a cyber cat does. Can they swing from a web? No, they can't. They're a cat.
Look out.
Where is she?
Here comes spider cat.
She should be under the
couch. Okay, she's not on the map yet. Okay.
That's what I'm saying. Put her on the map. Well, I'm going to put her where I think she was. I'm going to shrink her to the correct size. I'm going to give her 10 move, and you get going.
Right. I want... And...
Meow.
Yeah, I, wanted to press the button on the elevator.
Okay, the cat runs over, and she jumps up and she hits the elevator button, and she says, if you could do it for me, James.
Meow.
And at that exact moment, the elevator opens with Chrome being dodging two men trying to grab him. If Chrome, if you could
spit
yourself out of here.
I wanted to, like, make a really loud meow at the guys.
Meow.
Yeah. Meow.
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 Yes.
Here he is. Hold on, let me get some security guards out.
Think that's all I can do for it's now.
The cat alarm. Meow, 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 meow.
Meow.
A little light pops on top of his head, going, meow, meow, meow. This is an alert. Meow.
All right. Chrome, what are you doing? Make a...
They may have just saved your bacon.
No, well, maybe not, because he did specifically say he backed out of it. So let's go ahead and call this... And I'm trying to find a good way, a skill for not tripping over Gadget while you walk backwards behind them.
That would
dance. It's a dance. Yes.
No.
You don't. Shut up. He sold me. It's dance now.
Okay.
I mean, the actual answer would have been athletics, but it's dance now.
I just want to repeat the sentence that just came out. Shut up. He sold me.
Yes.
I didn't want to hear any other cases. I was sold.
Fine.
Unless you get the skill you're bad at.
Yeah. Like, I've got 10 in athletics. So I would have used that.
You fucking trip over Gadget.
Oh, right. I need to.
Yep. So we'll just say you're prone. Meow.
Meow.
You, Reggie, oh, you're
no,
being cool.
You've lived with her for however many years.
All right, Chrome, you hear in your earpiece. Okay, I got the thing. Where am I supposed to be taking it now? And that is the voice of Felicity. Because you agreed to 45% if Felicity helps you. And so she, when you ran out, she went and collected the gang chasler while everyone was distracted.
Wow, it's working.
It's working.
I'm not gonna lie to you, I did roll between she was gonna betray you guys. Yeah, no, I rolled and she rolled high on loyalty. I'm gonna take that weird shit you just said to imply to take it to the to the underground driveway. On it. And you see the other elevator is suddenly in use. Because reminder, there's an elevator on this side. No, this is all...
You're just in the... You're in the elevator hearing this conversation. There's just Girl from Ipanema playing.
Thank you. Yeah. Okay, remind me how sleep grenades work. Okay. Is it resist
drugs?
Yeah,
it's a confined space.
Okay, they get an 8. What do you say they need to get? 8, they get a plus 8. Which... they both got 8s on the die for a total of 16. So the door is closing because I got confused by the cat. So they got to make multiple rounds of surviving this. But for the first round, they're good. All right. Two security officers coming towards you, Ares. Please make your check for the second time.
Which one?
This is a security tech check to get this stuff out of here.
I'm gonna use luck. That did not make it better. That's one. You see, I can't use luck. It makes the roll worse.
You... alright. Is... these two guards are now going to make another... so move? Oh, that's right. They only have, like, a 4 move.
Fucking damn it, cocks. Sucking dice.
I was like, I'm worried this is gonna go too clean, was the thing I thought to myself before we came in today.
No, remember? You're perfectly fine.
It was going so good! And then I rolled.
Yeah. They're going to split up after this, but yeah, because they're not, like, worried that Ares is hostile. Alright, let's cut back over to our main man, Ryder. Rye bread. Yeah. Ryder, let's just check off. You are not doing so hot, my dude. You are up.
Okay, has Dasha answered?
Dasha, I will say now answers, because you got Dasha on the line.
You're plugged in.
I'm establishing an uplink as fast as I can. Unfortunately, my antiviral is still in here. It's making my job a little hard.
I look directly in Natasha's eyes. I'm distracting the runner.
Natasha does not understand what you're getting at.
I go immediately, punch her in the face, and I'm going to try and disarm her with my second attack.
Okay,
yes, you're
roll
distracting
for the...
her by getting shot.
Roll for the punch first.
Rolling plus 10. Oh, plus another additional plus 1 for persistent attack. So plus 11. 8 plus 11 for 19.
You got a 1 this time.
Oh, beautiful. And then for disarming, I assume. Next one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Luck. Okay, do I add brawling?
Yes.
15.
She got a 10 on the die, which alone is a 16, so I don't need to roll that support.
Would it be considered an attack?
I'm rolling evasion, so I mean, don't check how disarm works.
I assume defender wins.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, they got a 16 by default, and with a 10, I'm supposed to roll more.
Okay, wait. So with Aikido, the martial art that I chose...
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
When I hit the same target with a brawling attack and a martial arts attack this turn, we'll call the second. I can reroll it if you would like. Go martial arts instead.
Yeah, do that. But
okay. So for martial arts, plus 6, 9, 10, 16.
Okay, so that's a hit with the martial arts, and then let me double check the fuck this means.
A disarming combination. Once per turn, when you fulfill this requirement, you can use the martial arts special move resolution to attempt to beat a DV-15. If I succeed, any one held object in the hands of the target I hit twice this turn is either held by you or is now on the floor.
Okay, roll another martial arts check to see if you manage to do that.
Okay, DV-15.
Yeah.
That probably doesn't make it. No. Awesome. 13.
All right. You do hit her twice, so roll those, and it is at her halved armor, which is nice.
3. That's a crit.
That's 2 sixes?
Oh, it's 2 threes. I thought it was just 2 of the same number.
No, 2 sixes specifically.
Oh, okay. So 3, 6, and 4, 4, 10 for the first one.
Okay.
For the second one, 2, 4, 6, and 6 for 12 for a total of 22.
Okay. Gotcha. You gotta divide about my head because totals don't matter when armor is involved.
Yes.
There we go. Okay. That is the first time I think you've hurt her. Which, ow, it hurts. She's not seriously wounded yet or anything, but it hurts. Okay. And then she is going to sigh and roll her eyes, and she goes, I don't know if you know this, but generally speaking, gun does beat punch, yes?
We're going to find out. Actually, you know what? Can I use my remaining movement to attempt to take cover behind our servers?
Sure.
Okay.
Okay, this guy makes his move. He is apparently running into the other server room. You can see from the cage, you can see him just plugging something in and working on something. Because this is like metal bars, think like a cage.
Yeah.
You can see him over here. He is jacked into the server and is doing something.
Mm-hmm.
And she is going to... Hello. I think you lost me for a second there. And she fires again. She needs to beat a 13, which is to say a 3 on the die or higher. She gets a 6.
Oh. I'm gonna be real hurt in a second, folks.
Yeah.
Crit?
Can you roll was it 2d10 for the critical injuries table?
Sure.
Oh, no.
That's a 3 and an 8 for 11.
Okay. Friday night 5.
The secret is to not get shot.
Yeah, that's good. That's what I mean. I recommend not getting shot.
Loading a screen tip.
The thing is she's still in this room.
Yes.
So, really, if I leave, she can just take out the shard.
Oh, my bad. It's 2d6.
2d6, okay. Three.
With a 3, that's a dismembered fucking hand. Your hand is gone. You drop any items in that hand immediately.
No.
I raise my hand to attempt to like stop the bullet or something, and just bam.
Mangled.
And I just look at it and go. Ah! Good thing I wanted a new one of those.
Let's actually worry about damage now. Right.
You're lucky it's replaceable.
Yeah, you're gonna hate that my original thought, my first thought that popped in my head when this happened was that you'd slap her with the gutty wets of your hands.
Yes, 23 damage.
Could you imagine that you shot a dude's hand and it like exploded and there's just like bones and whatnot, and then he walks up and slaps you in the face with like the pieces of hand? You'd just throw up.
Are you seriously wounded, my man?
Hold on a second. Probably, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I am seriously wounded.
-2 to all your actions. Stabilize yourself is a first aid DV-13 roll.
I'm not going to lie. I'm finding it a little hard to believe that a Netrunner is out fighting a solo. But that is...
The dice tell a story, my guy.
Apparently.
Rolling well. Yeah.
Yeah, this is down the dice rolls.
Underestimated her.
Oh, it's possible.
You were like coming in expecting.
Yeah, you
have
done a lot of fist shooting. You've done no shooting instead. Except for the mediums. let me double check her ammo because she's made 3 shots so far, right?
Yep.
Okay, she's got 5 to go.
Yeah,
before she has to reload.
It's not gonna take that many to fuck me over, to fuck me up.
Nope. All right. Okay. Dasha's gonna make an attempt to get in. She's currently rolling with disadvantage because the antiviral is still in. She did not get in yet.
I'm going to attempt to run on my next turn, I figure.
It's a good move, good move. You are gonna have to push past her, but I'll let us roll for that. Do we want to stay in here, or do we want to cut back to everyone else?
Everyone else should probably do something.
Yeah, let's cut back. You are almost back to the office video. Okay.
I'm almost back to the office. I'm sitting there. I'm tapping on the dashboard, singing Cascada.
Jason's with you, just for support purposes. Jason's with you. Johnny Two Knives offered to come with you. Did you accept it?
I'm gonna say no because I really don't want him to die.
That's good. Yeah. He might. He is a pacifist, so yeah. He might die.
Yeah. So, but I say I appreciate that, but I think we could take it from here. There's a camera chameleon.
Okay.
Coming go.
Okay, with that, we'll call it Dr. Chrome's turn. We'll say it costs 2 move to stand back up.
I want to impose that as like a movie scene where they're just going side by side, like they're showing Rux and Jason singing and dancing in the truck. You see Ryder get his hand blown off and red.
Come on, all of this is like split screens.
This whole thing is set to that song. This whole heist is set to Carmen.
I'm about to put that song on. Chameleon. In the other elevator. I am pulling up the 1-hour version of Karma Chameleon. Oh, this is perfect. This is the vibe I wanted. This has made the entire thing better for me. We don't have the rights to play it, but just imagine it. Yeah, I was listening to serious music, but for anyone wondering, I was listening to a loop of the Flathead theme from the video game, which is like very tense and slow moving. But now it's better. Anyway, so that's Chrome. You called the elevator. On her turn, it will open with that. Next up, we're gonna have. I do want to do the guards on here once.
Oh, you're right. This is a vibe for this right now. I put it on too.
Okay, Ares, make a roll.
Okay. We gotta get Dash in.
I will tell you, it's becoming easier every time. You've just been rolling really bad.
Yeah. I'm going to grab a different die and use another fucking luck!
Come,
chameleon. Why am I even rolling?
What'd you get?
Got another one!
Okay.
It's another one after using luck!
So to be clear, this time the DV was 17. It's going down by 1 every time you fail, but unfortunately.
Oh.
So next time it'll be a DV 16. Okay. You're good at this. I didn't think that I needed to set the DV so low.
I wasn't expecting my luck to turn this bad.
Are you going off of the Netrunner stat block, or are you going off of another stat block?
Netrunner.
Okay.
It's 10 to handguns. Don't hold on. Don't look up the stat logs first of all.
Oh,
you're right.
Yeah.
You just upset that you lost your shit wiping hand.
A little bit.
I'll let you off this time, but if I find out that anyone's using the stat blocks, I do have more powerful versions than the stat blocks. I will switch to.
Fair enough.
Which is how I ended up with the 15 handgun the first time, and I was like, whoa, that's not right. Like, which you're glad, let's be happy I didn't do that, but I didn't keep with that. But the problem is that you're just in close quarters, and pistols are really good in close quarters. But she was still at full armor, so both of those medium shots did less than 11 damage. So, because she has the base 11 armor just above the table. Okay, so this guy doesn't know that Chrome's fucking shit up, so he's going after the cat.
Oh, right, yeah.
Meow. Meow.
And he's gonna run off.
Yeah, where's
Gadget?
We'll say when Gadget sees him walking towards him, it's going here, so I'll let you run past it's really good, isn't it?
It's such a vibe right now. It's amazing. It's weird because it's so tense right now, and the song is so non-tense. Like, I don't want Ryder to die, but I'm over here like, come a chameleon. This is incredible.
There we go. She's gonna start running this way.
Yeah, because like you find the right playlist for a movie, and you could make the whole movie on that.
Oh wait, is she small enough to fit under the desks?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so she's gonna stop there for now because that's. No, she could sprint for her action. So. Mm-hmm. Another 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. She'll come over here.
Start it over for me.
Ugh. Yeah, mine too.
And welcome back to this U.S. Open Office Plan.
Come over here.
Miller just lobbed a message way over Jones.
The stupid thought just entered my head of Gadget's trying to run under desks, but it's a robot cat, so it just isn't paying attention. Hits a desk and it's just running at full speed, but not moving with its head at the desk.
Yeah. It's more well programmed than that. Okay, now this guard is going to make his move. Unfortunately, he is going to go around because he doesn't perceive it as a threat yet. He's just confused. So he's going to go there. Next up, we're going to have this guard walk up, and he goes, I'm going to need you to step away from the computer, sir.
Why?
Because this is authorized for Thailand only.
You don't understand, dude. This computer has the best Wi-Fi in the entire building.
That's not how Wi-Fi works, dude.
It's got the best connection. I don't know how.
He has an inline. The rest they did Wi-Fi. He leans over where I assume you've put Minecraft up.
Yes.
So you're not in trouble, but let me phrase that. You're not about to be shot, but he does go, I'm gonna need you to get off this computer.
Can you at least let me get back to my bed? I want to save in my house.
Make a persuasion check.
Okay. 12. That's
12. Mm. He's going to give you one more round. He's not looking at the screen per se, so you're going to get one more attempt at this.
Yes.
If not, you might just be botched.
That was my plan, though. Okay, give me one more round to try this one more time.
Reminder that you guys have so far, let's say, successfully completed one job. So right now, your current payout is 2,000 to share.
Okay.
Okay. With that, we're going to cut over back to Chrome, in which you see the elevator door open. And Felicity waves and gestures inside, calmly and quietly.
The music cuts to an elevator version of Girl of Karma Camellia.
And she just... She hits the close button. Alright, we're going back to... We're gonna go back... I don't need to take you guys to that floor. We're gonna go back to the data floor. As I set something else up on a different floor. Well, I got it. Because stuff is happening a lot.
Yeah, we don't have eyes on Omwell.
You don't have eyes on Omwell, that's correct.
We do have a bug on him, though.
You have a bug in his office. Yeah. If anyone tap into that for free and know that he's not in his office. That's what I wanted him to be, though.
Oh, Beans.
That's where we have ears.
Why isn't he? You have ears in every security camera.
I also need to be at, like, a computer, though.
Yeah. All right. So let me cut back over to the data floor, because I was doing something else.
Yes.
Ryder, what do?
I spit blood.
That's reasonable. What else?
And,
into her face.
And I say into my microphone, Dasha.
Yes, me.
If I don't make it out of this, shot of agave syrup. Pour it over. Big glass in a highballer. Two shots of amaretto.
I'm gonna do my best to remember that while I also try to hack into the system so that you can live.
I attempt to rush into her.
You gonna tackle?
I don't think so. I think I'm just gonna go for another disarm.
Okay. Are you going to go for your disarming Aikido thing, or are you just going to go for a disarming check?
Disarming Aikido.
Okay. So you gotta attack twice and land both.
Yeah, one martial arts.
And one regular.
Actually, you know what? How's she looking? Like...
She's a little hurt. She's not seriously wounded, I'll say that. Reminding you of a -2 to your actions right now.
You're right, I do. Okay,
she wants you to leave, so I'll tell you that you can just run past her.
But if I leave, there's a chance that Dasha doesn't get it in.
You're correct.
I'm trying my best.
Fuck it, I put myself between her and her computer, and I'm just going to try and fucking feed her fists.
Okay.
Slap her. Yeah, slap her with the mangled hand. She's gonna throw up.
Yeah,
that hand's gone. It's honestly at this point like that's the hand that I'm trying to feed into her mouth.
Okay, so you just went for two hits.
It would be easier to swallow without the knuckles.
Yeah, two hits. Brawling check.
Okay.
First one is it would be a 14, however, I think she can probably get past that. I'll burn luck.
Red, gold, and green. Come, chameleon.
It's really good.
Go.
Fuck.
Yeah.
Okay, so the first one's a natural one.
Okay, unfortunately, I hate to tell you this. A 14 would have worked, but it did not. She got a 13, but okay. You burned luck. All right, come on,
she
got one more.
Yep. That is probably much better for 16.
She got a 14 on the second one. So you do, okay. Yeah, she, you gotta hit the first one. I'm gonna say you go with your, like, your missing hand, and she just easily just, like, you get blood in her face, but she doesn't actually get hurt.
Yeah.
And the second one is with a good left hook, right hook. I'll let you decide which hand gets dismembered.
The left hand got dismembered.
Okay, so then you get a good right hook in.
Okay, so
Ryder is right-handed, but I could be wrong.
He is 2, 4, fuck, only 6. That doesn't even break her armor, I don't think.
Her armor has lowered a little, so it did. Saving that. James knows all about saving treats for later. He's a fellow beardman.
And I'm going to use my remaining movement to 1, 2, 3, 4.
Heads up, this door is open. He did not bother to close it. And this guy just looks like a guy.
Oh, it just looks like a guy?
Yeah. He doesn't have a gun on him or anything. So
okay, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Not the red one, so it's concerning.
Yeah, Captain's
red. Yeah, I was going to say.
All the while he's trying to get out of there, he's like dragging himself on the wall. There's blood on it and shit, and yeah, Ryder doesn't look good.
These doors open up. These are gonna be the elevator if you want to try to risk that. Otherwise, this is gonna be your other fastest way down. Okay, Dasha is going to make another attempt. She's still at disadvantage.
Okay.
And that's a 1 on the die.
Okay.
She doesn't have luck?
She does not, no. And luck is for player characters. Unfortunately.
Could Nervous Steve have 1 luck?
I'll let Nervous Steve have 1 luck, but he is only a mild accomplice.
I'm just like, he got like that gigantic confidence boost after the bar.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Anyway, Natasha. You can see through the cages.
Go.
And she is in her Netrunner setup, which might make things very messy for y'all. But unfortunately, jacking in is an action, so she's not able to do anything this round. You are welcome to try to come back and fuck around and find out, but she is trusting that you are retreating. Right.
Just walk back in the room.
I invoke the fifth.
It's not.
Just walk back in and kick her square in the jaw, just like, bitch!
I didn't hear no hell.
Dodge this directly in the forehead.
I'm just picturing you don't even use your gun, you just walk in and just kick her.
Alright, Aries, your final chance.
Okay, I've been trying to manifest a 0. Come on.
I know you need a 16 in total.
Oh, well, that's an 18. We succeed this time.
Yes! Karma Chameleon, let's go!
Objective 2 complete.
Fuck yes, finally. Okay.
Objective 2 complete, and he's going to have you get up.
Yeah, I'll shut it down.
Island goes, what the fuck were you doing on my computer?
Dude. You have the best connection for Minecraft I've ever seen.
Don't I fucking know it? Why do you think it was already installed? And he daps you up.
Yeah. Sorry, dude. The distraction worked.
Don't ever fucking do that again, but hell yeah.
Never again. Sorry, right. Man.
We're gonna cut to the ground floor.
I got away with it.
I do believe you're coming out here, yes? Oh, you're heading to the basement. You're right. They assumed you were going to the ground floor. Ah, that's right.
Yeah.
Ah, you're right. You fooled even me because I forgot you were going to the basement.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. No, you.
The most convincing lie is one that you believe.
Hold on. Here, you know what? Those are, they passed their save every time. Those are, two of those guys are the knocked out guy, the guys you got with the sleep. Yeah, I've been rolling for it. I gave them 3 attempts and they passed all 3.
Fuck.
They don't. Christopher Omwell's the one who knows which elevator you're in. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to roll a D10 on an 8, 9, or 10. Christopher Omwell push the button. If not, he was too confident to, like, push the button and you just go past him. Are we ready? Hold drum roll, please.
And green, red, gold, and green. Come a chameleon. Come and go. Come and go.
He pushed the button, so therefore. All right, that was the best I could do to show my role.
Get in the ceiling tiles. Get in the ceiling tiles. Go in the shaft.
Like 5 seconds. Okay, what are you pulling? Okay. You open the door. The door opens. You throw an EMP through. Remind me what you got to do for an EMP. Okay. Let's see here. Correct. Yeah. Let's see here. Believe it or not, Christopher Omwell has a really good stat in that. He says DV15. Omwell's doing fine. Let's check these 4 guards. I'm not gonna count you though.
Come on, all down.
Pass on a 1, but a 1's a fail.
Well, on a 1, you roll. You actually are supposed to roll again and subtract. But it just doesn't matter so often. But we often hand wave past that. Alright, let's see here. These guys. They get a +2 to cybernetics, so we'll see if they happen to roll 10s.
Love is strong when you run. Gone forever. Sing along. Could they have a bunch of hands? You never know. Are the guns cyber?
Even with 2 of them rolling a 10, only 1 of them passed. So the other 3 just... Their robo arms that Christopher Omwell hooked them all up just fall limp. You gotta be kidding me.
Can he get the door closed before they get in?
I'll make him make a roll for it.
Oh my god, please.
Are you fucking...
Something has to go right in the side.
Yes.
I did it again. I got another 10 on Omwell.
Oh no!
I don't have to. They have paid off a lot more than they've done, you guys. This is just a bad session for y'all. Alright, well, he's going. I was going to say the door closes almost, and then his robot hand gets in there and shoves it open. And he gets in, and he immediately hits the close button.
Oh.
He just waves. He goes, Felicity. Dr. Omwell. Ezekiel. As you guys are getting down to the ground floor, which I will say Rux is now at.
Yeah.
Oh. That does make things interesting.
A mango.
Yeah. It's really good.
Loving you is easy. The colors are like my dreams.
No.
Nope. You use it to throw the grenade. It just looks at you and goes, yeah, he's my kid. I didn't want you guys to know he was a Nepo baby. I got the baby part right in my right. He elbows you.
He elbows you really hard.
Really hard. With his non-robotic arm, I'm looking at the angle. He does it. All right, let's cut back up to the data floor. Ryder?
Ryder? As he immediately begins to turn around, he mutters to himself, "En el nombre del Padre, del Hijo, y del Espíritu Santo." 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And what would you constitute as forcefully jacking somebody out so that they experience all of their net architectures, black ice, and shit? Like, would an attack do that, or?
You know, I don't think there's a lot of.
I know that not jacking out of something before leaving a net architecture fucks you up.
There is a grab action. It just uses dex brawling.
Wait, actually, where's her gun?
That's it.
I guess okay. I'll take the gun out of her holster and just fucking throw it.
Mm-hmm.
She's still in the.
Yeah, I'll say I'll let you do that for free as your action.
As my action.
Yeah, as your action. I'm saying I'm not gonna make you roll for it.
Okay.
But it is going to take your action because that's how the mechanics of this game work.
Then instead, I will just attempt to forcefully eject her from a net architecture. I'm not sure how I would do that. I just know that when I do that, it's going to fucking hurt her.
Yeah.
Yep. I did just find the consequences, which helps.
Cool, cool, cool. Yeah, I was looking for it.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to call that a grab. So she gets to use her evasion. I'm going to give her a sort of disadvantage.
So this is using brawling, if I remember right?
Yes.
Okay. That would be a 6, 10 minus 2 for 14.
You got a 13. Yep. Yank her out.
She should experience a buttload of brain damage.
Yeah, I'm on it. Give me a second. A lot of things are happening all at once.
Yep.
Yeah, her systems are error.
You come and go. It's the best part of the song.
My dreams. There's a breakdown with
a heavy drum to it. It's just been
yeah. We're all fighting over Jax is just strolling down the street.
I'm calling my shot right now that I want the scene that we're gonna go with. I'm calling this now. I'm going outside of tradition of me going last. I want Rux and Jason in the cab of the truck jamming to Karma Chameleon with like the scenes on the outside of everybody else of like the shit they're going through.
Yes. Yeah.
It's like Ryder getting his hand blown off.
Minecraft on the computer.
It's the Jim Carrey meme, but with his hand instead.
It's in the bone.
Also the Jim Carrey meme where he's like answering emails.
It's just a bunch of Jim Carrey memes. Because it's the dumbest. It's Jim Carrey and Dumb and Dumber in the dog truck.
I do gotta say, by the way, Goon, I've loved all of the art that you put out so far. It's been awesome.
Yeah.
You sent me the image of the yup. I have arrived. It's like the anime fisheye lens of when somebody does something crazy. Like,
oh, you're talking about like the oh no, I was. Yes. That.
But move it out. You get.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, she is confusing it with the Kubrick stare.
She is very disoriented, but she is not dead. She's not looking good though.
Do I have another action?
A grab is unfortunately the action, so.
Okay.
You have if you have any movement left, it's all yours. But
one, two wait, no, I don't. Yeah, I ain't running.
You come and go.
As he forcefully jacks her out, she like gains some kind of vision of him. I didn't hear no bell.
Natasha did not understand many things, but she understands you least of all. All right. Okay. Okay.
The ocean was amused by my comeback.
Okay. Underground. Rux, I will say you've gotten to your car at this point. Are you going to switch the music on in your car?
Yeah, switch the I'm able to. Is there anybody who's like there for the truck, or am I able to just get into Rosie?
There's security and stuff, but they don't currently know the job like that.
Okay.
So you can just get into Rosie.
All right. So I'm gonna hop into Rosie, and I'm gonna pull up the truck past Rosie so that Jason can get out and like dip into Rosie without being seen.
Okay.
I don't want him getting caught. So.
We'll call that a stealth check from him. Which he gets plus 10 to. Alright, that's an 18. I'll send
I'm going to cause a distraction by cranking the volume on the radio.
Yeah, and he's going to dive into the back of Rosie and just stay ducked down so he's not seen.
I'm sure that, like, as a disguise for the truck, I have, like, tarps and stuff back there to make it seem.
Yeah,
able to just kind of jump in and pull a moving blanket over himself.
Yep. You get to your car. Yep. Where are you taking it?
So for now, I'm going to pull the vehicle out to the street.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just going to kind of like wave at the security guard if he catches my eye leaving. So
They see you. They seem a little distracted. Like one of them, we'll say he's actually right here, and one's kind of aimed at the door, or like the elevator doors.
I should probably check in on the radio and see if you guys need help clearing out, getting to the basement.
Yeah, you hear in Rosie. Yeah. You hear as you get in the car from Rosie, as soon as you like are closed in the, you're no longer going to be heard by the guards. I've been listening to your friends. It seems that they are in quite a lot of danger.
Well, shit, what kind of danger are we talking about, Rosie?
I heard a loud scream from Rosie. I believe that Dr. Chrome is with his dad. Sorry, from Rosie. From Ryder. I heard a loud scream from Ryder. It appears Dr. Chrome is with his father, whatever that means.
Oh, well, hell.
Arius, honestly, not doing that bad.
I kind of expected that one.
Honestly, that one just
I was at least surprised about that one.
Yeah. He's very covert.
All right, I'm gonna knock on Dr.
Chrome expects to meet you down here. Which may draw suspicion from the guards over there.
Can I do a quick kind of like peek around? There's only the two guards?
Only the two guards down here. I didn't do Dash's check. I just now did it. So you hear the classic, Ryder, you hear, I'm in. She says that in a dark, gravelly voice. I had to. She looking as you see her, you hear her connect. She goes, "Yeah, sorry. I just had to. Holy shit, everything's a disaster there. Fuck, guys. Holy shit. I don't know what I was expecting. Is everyone gonna live? Do we think?"
I'm
okay.
Come and go. Loving you was easy if you can live in my dream.
It's just heavy breathing on Ryder's head.
Golden green. Red, okay. Golden green.
What does Ares say? Because Ares, you are surrounded by people.
Oh, am I?
Well, yeah, you're in an office full of people. Let's cut over there. Yes. Yeah, reminder that you're in an office full of people being escorted by a guard back to your desk. The cat, I'm just going to say at this point because I forgot about it, I'm just going to say the cat got away.
Okay, yeah, she, like, loops around a few times, and then she's, like, hiding under mine.
Yeah, she's under your desk, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, so, I'm real sorry about this, guys. I didn't think I'd be too long on there.
Ryder, you hear her
here. Do not go in there. Woo!
Ryder, you're in your ear. There's four guards coming out of the elevator in a moment. I'm doing everything I can to stop it, but I'm just establishing connection.
Don't worry about it.
He's coughs up blood on the floor.
Man, it would suck if that happened. Okay. I'm going to say, meanwhile, underground, the door gets halfway open and stops.
Oh, hell.
And you see two guards outside. Hold on, I'll put the other ones. You see the two guards outside. You see, Felicity just slides you the gang jazzler at this point. She goes, I think my work here is done. The Gang Jazzler is a piece for your hand that basically puts a taser in your hand. It is a prototype for a new, much more powerful model.
is it like the equalizer gloves?
I don't know what they look like off the top of my head. I'd have to look it up again. But I think they're internal, so you
can unlimited power!
Yes, yes. No, it needs to be installed. You see him go, you see Dr. Christopher Amoko. I can't wait to see how you get out of this one, son. The door's halfway open, which is unfortunate, if anything. We return to the data floor. Natasha is scrambled, but she's reaching for something on her desk. You're not sure what, because she doesn't seem to get to it yet. As you hear the sound of guards trying to force a door open, Nervous Steve goes, hey man, I don't think this is gonna go well if they get through. I'll do what I can. So Ryder, you are in the center of the building. You've taken care of your main threat, but you have four other secondary threats about to come through. You, Christopher Omwell, are stuck in an elevator with guards at the exit. Ares, you're doing fine. And Video James, aka Rux Bastion, you are doing fine. And I think that's where we're gonna end it tonight.
What floor are you on?
He's on the ground. He's about to exit out of the floor you're on, the underground.
No, I'm talking about Ryder, who's like surrounded.
Oh, he's on floor pretty much.
Second to top floor. Yeah. Well, there's the rooftop as well, but yeah. It's ground floor, offices, servers, C-suite, rooftop.
I'm not gonna lie. I don't see Ryder making it out of this.
We'll find out next week.
Yeah.
We will.
I have a plan. We can talk about it.
We'll see how it goes.
At this point, Ryder needs to kill this woman.
Uh-huh.
Like, for personal reasons now.
Point of pride.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to give everyone 60 points for this week.
Woo!
Woo!
I've still yet to spend any.
Yeah, I think I said we got to spend them in between missions. You can't do it in the middle.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine. There we go. Did my stuff
How are we feeling, folks? Honestly, this is going better than I thought it was going to at the beginning of the session.
Yeah.
Yeah, I rolled between sessions, and she rolled high, so I took that to mean that she was going to help you, because that was your agreement. There was a chance she was going to rat you guys out, and that didn't happen, which is very lucky.
I am not feeling bad.
I'm very glad.
Yeah, no, this is, you had the opportunity to run away, and you didn't, so I don't think you can feel, like, too ashamed
no,
right
no,
now.
I have made my choice, I have made my bed, I will lie in it.
I don't want to give you ideas, but I am going to say that I will look up the rules for fall damage and remind you that behind Natasha is a window.
Yep, cool. I'm pretty sure
I'm not saying you have no exit. I'm not saying you have to do that, but I'm saying there are options. I don't know fall damage in this game.
I think my best bet would probably be the maintenance ladders in the elevator shaft. But that relies getting there, and that nervous Steve can hold back four dudes, which, don't get me wrong, he's fucking jacked and just absolutely
a
specimen of a man.
Steve, yeah.
I feel like we should be taking him with us at this point.
Are there windows available
where
he is?
Obstructing them.
There's windows up. Yeah, there's windows up there.
Okay.
But I know what I'm going to do, and in the probable case that Ryder dies because of it, I am fully okay with it. Because I believe this is what the character would do in the moment.
Yeah. In case you're wondering, it would be 6d6 soaked by body armor. A broken leg injury, yeah.
Absolutely flattened. Pancake. Like Rebecca and Edge Runners, absolutely just...
That was sad.
Yep, we're getting Karma Chameleon, baby. I'm still jamming. It's so good right now.
I need a gadget a la Untitled Goose, just taunting the guards.
Yeah, just
like
running
under
between
a desk
desks.
As they like have the like frustrated. Bubbles.
The word bubble over gadget is just a very blocky, like robotic looking font that just says meow.
No.
Yes.
I also have a gadget themed one, which is I want Chrome tripping over gadget. Knocking Chrome over.
Oh, I was watching someone play Little Kitty Big City, and you can like sprint at people and trip them. It's so
Hell
much
yeah,
fun.
Dude.
A piece I'm entitling "The Last Ride," spelled with a Y, and it's him walking down the hallway, saying in Spanish, "In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit," as he prepares to walk into the room of a jacked in Netrunner and exact his vengeance.
One last ride.
Ups and downs, because you've been riding in the elevator like the entire time.
Karmic justice.
Karma is actually not a bad name for this one. Yeah. Karma. I feel bad for James, who just got to listen for the whole session.
I have plans for the next time, and honestly, it just kind of worked out that way, like, Rux is just kind of a charming old man.
Yeah, and you also had the since you didn't have the initial complication, which is what everyone else was revolving around, you just didn't have to deal with anything.
Well, my complication comes at the end of this, which is getting everybody out. So, I understand. My part of this is done for the most part up until everybody else finishes, and then it's get the hell out of here.
Cosmic Library.
Everyone, let's all vote for a different one so that there's a forced runoff election.
Flamingo. Loving it easy, the colors were like my dream. Red, gold, and green.
I've already voted.
Yeah, because I was the only one who voted on the runoff.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, Camellia. Come and go. Come and go.
Okay. Thank you all for coming.
I'm going to
my dream.
I've been Kelvin, a.k.a. Noodle Doodler, a.k.a. Noodle Goon, a.k.a. your Gonk Master for this evening, a.k.a. the man who killed Ryder. We'll never know. We'll know next week. But that's what they call me, he who killed Ryder. That's the fifth title. Anyway. The Writer's Bane. That's it. That's what I want. That's the name of weapon and fire emblem. It's good against cavalry units. Anyway. Speaking about cavalry units, first off, we have a man who knows a lot about horses, I imagine. Dr. Chrome, as played by Noodle Goon. Not Goon Noodle. Right forward. This is the best session.
I was gonna say that it was like we were all expecting Chrome to have the hardest time with us, and it turned out that Ryder was having the hardest time with a goddamn computer nerd.
Fucking nerd.
Nerd.
Anyway,
dweeb over
the good here. News for the good news is now just like peek behind the curtain. She now gets a -4 to all her actions, which will make it a lot harder. She has she has brain damage, a brain injury, and she's that seriously wounded. Because, by the way, the rule just says that if you get removed during your setup, you're in a world of pain, and there's no further expansion. So I had to think about what it meant. A world of pain. Those are the exact. It's bold, like it means something, but it doesn't.
She brought it upon herself by getting cocky about like, this guy, he's got no hand and walked away.
Well, she confidently thought that he took the opportunity to leave, and now she's like, I guess he has to die. Like, Ryder chose.
What she was about to do.
I don't want to be this guy, but Ryder chose death. Like, if he dies, this was because of his decisions.
100%.
She was fine with him leaving.
He was not.
Yep. He already took his hand. She was like, yeah, I guess he can go now.
What I am glad for is this does not this hopefully does not endanger anyone else.
Yeah, so far, I think good. Speaking of people completely not in danger, we have Alex, a.k.a. Ares, a.k.a. Moss Creature.
Yeah, things were looking rough for a sec, but they all worked out for me, and Gadget had fun tormenting.
Speaking of rough, we have our ride or die writer, aka Smokey DeBlaze.
A shot of agave syrup, a shot of cognac, served in a highball with crushed ice.
You said two amarettos last time.
No, I did. Yeah. I changed it.
Okay. Are you telling this to Dasha again?
He changes the drink every.
I don't know. Put some fucking things in a highball.
A glass of orange juice with three shots of vodka.
that's delicious. That's delicious.
That's like a maniac mimosa.
A can of Miller High Life with an additional can of Miller High Life with it. Believe it or not, a third can of Miller High Life.
And two shots of amaretto.
Two shots of amaretto and an orange juice.
These are all
calling a beer mosa.
It's kind of like a flight, like it comes to you on like a ship of all 7.
The reason I changed is because I forgot that amaretto was an apricot liqueur and not a. And not something else, and agave syrup, and
it would taste good with Chambroy.
I was thinking of Hennessy, actually. Really? That's why I changed it to a cognac.
Anyway, Yes. Speaking of drinking, a man who I assume drinks from time to time. It's Vox Bastion, aka Video James.
You. Man, we're just jamming a Karma Chameleon this whole time.
Still
the whole time, and still playing.
Karma Chameleon.